Hey guys, guess who went to a rummage sale and got this thing? Well, me. Just to give you the answer right there. But look at this. This is a very vintage black and white TV from JCPenny. The electronic bar tuning. What that is, for people who won't know what this is, because I've used this unit before, pretty much what it is it has a black line that goes through the screen that actually goes across and lines up with the numbers on this. But the problem with it is that the channels are all bonkers on here. They're scattered around every which way. Channel 3 is in the correct spot, you know, TBS and all that. But the weird thing is that, like, you know how UHF, you get all of these channels, right? Like 14 and all that? Well, what's weird is all of the channels are concentrated in a very small space from about the end right here between the 2 and the 4, and it probably receives all of the channels between that and 40. So it's a very narrow space to receive channels on this thing. This thing works beautifully otherwise. Here, I will show you everything about this TV. You know what's weird about this? They have double of the same JCPenney sticker on this and here. Now, they may look a little different to you, but that's pretty much just because one has a smaller space to deal with. They both say, well, at least get across the same exact thing. So, as you see from here, it is a IC. I'm guessing that means interconnected solid-state TV receiver. It doesn't say that it's black and white, but I assure you it's black and white. The model number is 685-10-33. Now, this TV, I found it strange. When you read at the top, it says AC, DC, and battery. But you can't remove that thing. It says open right there, which I figured would eject it. But then they got screws right here. So I'm wondering if you gotta unscrew that first before you can remove this and swap it out with a battery bay. The only disadvantage is when I got this from the rummage sale, they only had the AC bay. Which is fine because you would never want to make these things portable or DC anyway, considering that they can't receive anything with today's digital antenna TV, as these are analog and they are officially obsolete. What I like about Time Warner is that they broadcast in digital and analog for all of your analog needs, so you won't need a DTV converter unit. You guys probably noticed these two. They're for the plastic mount over here. I believe I have showed you this TV before. This is a Philips AC-DC VCR TV. Works beautifully. There is not one issue with this thing. But I was setting this thing down and forgetting to remove this plastic panel, and you could probably see it. It is scraped up all over the place. And you could see those scratches while watching TV. Well, that isn't very fun. So I just thought, you know what? Screw the plastic cover, even though it's really cool. Screw it, because it's not going to work with it very nicely. I mean, it protects the screen, but from what? What are you going to be throwing at the screen that you need to protect it with a plastic covering? I apologize for the rumbling. That is my furnace, which you have seen in my update video, I believe. What is this? Something leaking. Ugh, gross. Ugh, man, gunked up my TV. That's pretty gross. Well, anyway, this unit works perfectly.
Sign up today. It's Pep Boys Spring Tire and Car Care Event, featuring mobile
yada yada yada. Pep Boys, all of that crap.
Reduce wear and
beautiful color, beautiful picture, and it's a very clean signal. I apologize for my iPod being all funky, because you know, CRTs and cameras do not agree with each other. But you might be able to notice this TV has like beautiful, beautiful picture on it. And I got it from a garage sale for like $2. How awesome is that? VCR works perfectly. Oh, man. It's underneath it, too. Now my fingers are sticky. I'm concerned because it's yellow. Oh, it's been dripping from that. Oh, there's something disgusting up there. I don't even want to pull up that panel because I'm scared of what I'm going to find. Ew. That's disgusting. That is just nasty. Well, remote and everything for this thing. This thing was a heck of a deal. They had everything for this. They even had the DC adapter for the car, which is very hard to get with these units when you get at a garage sale. Usually the owners just sell it as is without a remote or the DC adapter for these portable televisions. I don't know. I mean, portable VCR TVs, I guess, are sometimes convenient, but a lot of people like watching DVDs. I believe you people have seen my I can't think of the name of it, but it's a portable DVD TV. It's pretty much this, just updated. It's pretty much all it is, but it's not a Philips. I know that. Sorry, I don't remember. It's in my sister's room now, so whatever. She wanted a TV really bad, and I told her once I get a new color TV, I am going to give her my old one. Something fell back there. Whatever. Here's the back of this one. I know, like, I get kind of carried away in my videos. I realize that. But, I just thought it would be cool of showing you this unit before I just unplug it to show you how this black and white vintage TV from May 1981. I know. Old as freaking crap. Old. Very old. But working. The digital tuning bar was a very brilliant idea, but for some reason it failed on this TV because the channels are all mixed up. And I know that because if you watch a TV and you have it set to the channel, you can tell pretty much none of the channels on this TV are in the correct spots anymore. Like, Fox 6 News is on channel 7. Wait, no, it's like in between it. Like, the channels aren't even spaced out how they describe it here. Junk. No, what happened with this TV to make the tuning go all wonky? But everything else on this TV is working beautifully. In case you want to know, it's a AC 120 volt. I know that probably a lot of you have gone to Aussie 50s channel. I believe that's how you pronounce it. Now, I believe his voltages are like 220 around there, but ours is 120. It's a 60 hertz, 11 watt television. So this is pretty efficient, I guess you would say. Here is my like early 2000s black and white TV with an unknown brand. It's a NTSCM system. It's pretty much the same exact thing as this, just updated. It's a 5.5 inch black and white TV with AM/FM radio. The AM/FM radio works good in here. The tuner works good. Everything about this TV works great. The antenna was very poorly designed. The little place where you attach the wire to the antenna, what it was is, it was just a bracket, and this was just soldered on by a very poor soldering joint. If you could see it, sorry. iPod camera. But, they designed these really weird, because if you twist the antenna around enough, it'll put a lot of tension on this wire. After a while, it'll get so twisted, snap, it's off, and it just broke off from the wire. Well, that doesn't really matter anyway, because analog broadcasting is obsolete. It works great. I don't have the proper power adapter. I use my Compaq LTE 5000 power adapter. It is an 18 volt rating on it, but this TV works fine with 18 volts. I guess it can go up to 18 volts. Doesn't have to, but it can, I guess. I don't know. Because it works fine with a 12-volt TV, but it does get crazy hot, so that might be an issue. It's got an antenna in and a left-channel headphone jack. It's got video and audio, which works perfectly. You don't even have to tune it to a channel. You don't even have to do that. It will just go straight to AV input for it. Then it's got your standard V-hold control, contrast control, and brightness control. I'll show you the controls on the new vintage 80s, like early 80s, black and white television. It is only a TV receiver. It's not AM/FM, as I said from the label reading. It's got an antenna in, a recording port. I have no idea what that does. I don't know. I have no idea. Why would they do that? I don't get it. It doesn't do anything. It literally doesn't do anything. I don't know what to say about that. And then it's got a, believe it's a mono earphone jack, which also works beautifully. Of course, it's got its on-off and volume knob. Then it's got the UHF and VHF switch, pressed in UHF, pressed out VHF. And it's got a channel check system. What that does is pretty much when you click it in to check, it just has that black bar going on permanently when it says check. But the neat thing about that black bar is, when it tunes into a channel, it'll show up, and then it'll just narrow in and just disappear. And it does the same thing when you let go of it. The black bar will be there. It's gone. You know, it is a quite unique JCPenney television set from the 80s. It's got a really good speaker in it. When I first plugged this in, I was concerned because when I turned it on, it was actually able to pick up a couple radio stations for some reason. I don't know. It was weird. And it's not a AM/FM radio. It was weird. It was picking up, like, hip-hop and all of that, you know. All of the hip-hop now, but as a lot of people might have noticed that, like, on the hip-hop, like, purely hip-hop stations like Kiss FM, they have, like, the new songs that are coming out, like, more and more of them are sounding just like R&B instead of hip-hop, and I hate R&B. I am sorry. Way too slow. It's just awful. Well, anyway, let's, screw this, you know what, no, let's keep that on because that thing is a heck of a thing to get on this television. Unscrew it from the wall here. Sorry. Takes a while to unscrew for some reason. There it is. And then the power cord for the TV. Best thing I like about this TV, if the power is disconnected from it, it still saves the channel at which it was at. So if I plug it in at the end of the video, it'll be the same channel as it was when I first had it on to just show you guys how perfect this TV works. And I've gotten this TV a while ago. It's just an amazing, amazing find. Just, I love rummage sales, garage sales, yard sales, all of that. Because you can get a lot of this crap. It's amazing. Like this, you could get a lot of vintage. I am a sucker for vintage. It was marked for $10, believe it or not. But the lady only sold it to me for $5. So, that's quite a better price for it. I don't have the proper antenna attachment, so a lot of people are probably going to be laughing at my connection. Because it is a very complicated network connection. Oh, God, what is that? It's, like, dripping. That's just disgusting. We really need to check that out. I don't know what that is. It's just disturbing. Ugh. Gross. I don't even know what to call that. That's repulsive. And it smells. This basement smells. That is tiny compared to that thing. This thing, it's pretty much all airspace in there. It's very empty. It's a very basic CRT that's in here. It's a very basic tube. It's not too crazy. I don't want to crack open the vintage. Don't want to crack open the vintage because it's working fine. I mean, I'd hate to risk breaking something that is still working. I hate it when people throw out stuff like this. But then my dad, what he did was, I think I might have shown you guys the portable LTEC Lansing speakers that I had. My dad is just like, hey, what do you need these for? You don't need those anymore. So he took them and threw them in a box as well as the original Xbox that was pretty much trash anyway, so that's okay. But he threw the box in the crusher before I could take the speakers out. I'm kind of sad about that. But I kept the controller because the controller still works. I kept the DVD playback system and the playback adapter on it, and the cord extension reel right there. Yeah, all of that works beautifully, so there's no point in throwing away something like that that's still working. Well, anyway, first, the coaxial cable. Sorry, took me a while to think there for a second. Reach down there, plug it in, bring the cord back up because it's stupid. Oh, it's almost too short. You know, no, that is not going to work with this. First, make this TV, set it down here. Vintage. You gotta love that handle. Very light bin, so, whatever. That is sad. If you try to watch news on that, you're screwed. You won't be able to see crap. I don't know. I might make a funny video with this in it. I don't know. Keep you guys guessing, and I won't tell you the answer. Or will I? I don't know yet. They must have been, like, painting or something with this. What the crap? What? Got a spider web on it somehow already. Figures. Spiders got to ruin the vintage. They must have been, like, painting or something, because they got paint on the cord. Oh, and the cord's brown. See that? Why would they make the cord brown? It's a very dirty unit. I'm definitely going to clean it, because it's got a lot of filth in it. It smells around the antenna. Not like burnt electronics. I don't know. It smells really gross. Well, I don't know if you guys have ever smelt it, but it smells like, I don't know, almost like a burnt maple syrup. I don't know. Well, it turns on. I'll just let you see the tube warm up first. That is the black line I'm talking about. Watch. Turn the dial. The bar moves. Yeah, it's just flashing. It's not receiving anything. Don't worry, people. It's not receiving anything yet. Let's see. It's on VHF first. That's what I want it at right now. Then I got this crazy contraption here. It's an old IR cable from my Pioneer stereo. Used to connect to the tape deck, but I don't need to use this for the tape deck anymore. But okay, so put this in the exterior antenna port. Here, turn up the volume. It's a very loud television. Pretty good speaker in it. Very good speaker, actually. See if I can situate this right.
Who could forget Alexander Queen Gelm that showed up?
Hold on, gotta get a good connection here. Not the vintage.
That brush over on Kate's finger. I pronounce. Once again, Nancy, you're right.
Buckingham Palace to witness a guest.
Sorry.
Correspondent Victoria Arbiter says there's a good reason why we haven't heard of a new heir to the throne just yet.
But there was never going to be. The back bar goes away when it tunes into a station here. Ugh, I'm sorry. It's an awful connection.
Considering they shared their wedding with approximately 2 billion people, this really will be just.
There it is.
And just what would one get them for an anniversary? How about a song?
Well, okay, I just want to tell you, to
you. Thank you, sis. There's just nothing in there. Oh, you think I'm lying about this? Oh, stop it.
Hello.
That's enough.
He's a man today.
Sorry. Trying to get a good connection for you guys. Can't wait until I get a proper antenna connection for it. Let's see, it gets very clear picture. Way down the coaxial cable. There it is.
What is my brother doing here?
See, that's TBS, so it's in about the right spot. It can receive, like, every channel, like, beautifully.
Get an amazing 0.9% APR financing for 60 months on a new 2012 Sienna. Now that's
oh, yeah.
A lot for less. Toyota.
Hate you, Toyota. See, they're perfect picture, perfect sound. No static at all. I love it.
Comes adventure. It's all at Universal Orlando Resort. Vacation Pack.
Kenosha TV. Oh yeah, great.
For dessert.
Yeah, I like a nice pork chop once in a while.
Fine, I'm not gonna tell you how to eat.
Really?
It's got that white bar though. That's weird, but it works, so.
Your face look like a pizza!
One more ticket.
Alright, okay. Here, get my Jeep!
What time?
Now!
No, I need
an incredible story about perseverance and patriotism.
Yep, channel 20. For some reason, it's way over here. See, there's something wacky.
Feliz Navidad, mi amor. Soy el perro más feliz del mundo, Perú.
It's AFV in Spanish. Yum. Sorry.
qué viniste?
Oye, veo que tu familia es...
bastante grande, ¿verdad?
Bueno, ¿qué te puedo decir?
Mira, te presento a mi suegra querida.
Ah, mucho gusto. Ella es doña Rebeca. Mucho gusto.
Nothing like some Spanish television.
Shooting off the end of the shoe by the end of the day.
Mmm. The Shopping Network.
I was just saying, for Michael, it's like watching the show at home. He's just watching other people play. All right, Michael, now. Oh, it's a prize puzzle, too. There you go.
Yay. Yeah. Let's play the Wheel of Fortune.
I'll go out and I will try to find something for her, okay?
See, that's another
Thanks, man.
CW. I don't remember. Ugh. Disconnected again. Stupid.
This print measures 29 inches by 25 inches. A certificate of authenticity is included. Our next item, 2719, is a framed, signed, and numbered print titled Stone Farm, painted by Mouth and Foot Painters Association artist Jeffrey Ladal.
That looks fun too. No.
Now everyone can be online at the same time.
Wow. Chatting, yep. Time Warner. Love it.
Streaming with our pepper. And you know, we're also waiting for Jennifer Lopez, Elizabeth Banks, and Cameron Diaz to have their babies as well.
What are you doing?
Decorating. The office. I think. Maybe. I don't know my shows. Like that.
But it sure seems to imply that those who reject Christ,
the Christian network,
have a hard time at the very least.
Ah, Family Guy. Seriously? See, that doesn't come in. What the crap? Then you get Cartoon Network. Skips like 30 channels. Yay, AMC. It's a good network.
All right, I'll talk to him.
A very old movie. TV Land. NBC. Some commercial. Or no. BTN. I don't know. The Weather Channel. See, these are all over the place. Well, the Weather Channel is kind of in a good spot, but where the heck are the 60s all the way over here? It's messed up.
Imagine facing the day with less chronic osteoarthritis pain.
I don't have chronic arthritis pain or whatever they said. The Oprah Winfrey Network. The Food Network. Wait, things look so much better in black and white, don't they? And then, just nothing. Yay, the Static Channel. My favorite channel of all. Never understood this. Just blank. A bunch of messed up audio. Yeah.
Mom wants you to order pizza and make popcorn.
Alright, I will. Nothing like static. Ooh, or some interference channels. Yum. Tasty. Well, that's the Vintage. Vintage checks out. But it's too bad the tuner's all messed up. At least it receives channels, so it's not completely messed up. So, I mean, it's working. Just not to its full potential for some reason. I don't know. I might crack this open just to find out what the heck is wrong with this thing. Let's go back to something good. Yay, more Food Network.
And makes them his own.
Jamie Harris, we will get that voice, sir.
We're oh yeah.
Then,
Oprah Winfrey.
And those gardening gloves.
Plants.
Max and Redbox, Time Warner Cable. Enjoy movies better.
Okay. Yum. Culver's is good.
Gone and done it.
I've done what here?
That's just like my music from the heart.
A lot tougher than this before. The plaza diversion. Get out of here. I'm back.
Greatest worker, so I have to put all the
Ew, Disney Channel. Gross.
It's a cool Chuck world.
Cartoon Network is better. It won't receive Nick. No, of course not. It only receives the not as good channels. See, it won't go over any further. It's gone. UHF.
Now, learn about a program committed to you and copay assistance that can reduce monthly Orencia out-of-pocket drug costs to $5.
I told you not to play in front of my house. This time, I'm keeping it. And you're not getting your rock back either.
Connection is weird.
Are you still down on the dumps? Come on, it's just a chick.
You ever heard of a little thing called feelings?
I've heard of the thing called feelings.
I approve this.
Oh, you do approve that message. Oh, good, because I was worried that you didn't. Because I'm so concerned about what you approve.
She knows. Nancy can hit you year-round, indoors or out. Prescription Nasonex is clinically proven to help relieve nasal allergy symptoms any time of...
For some reason, Ion network is not working, right? Piece of crap. Piece of junk. See, it's clear. If I get it like that, it's perfect. If it'll just sit like that. Oh yeah, you know everything. There it is. Guess it's okay, but it's still weird. Knob's dusty. I'll cuddle in that. Washington Middle School. Yep, KUSD 20.
Kenosha Unified School District.
Oh yeah, more Spanish. Yeah, that's something you see. A very old guy speaking Spanish. Like, a very old white guy. I mean, I guess that's sometimes common, but... They're just...
Shoes. $0.46, and this one is something that you know. You look at and say, "I cannot."
It's like punch the screen. Oh, angry. How your art and how your now it's a little bit clearer. That's weird.
You got a chance to.
Yay! Wheel of Fortune.
one round, but it was a biggie. You did very well. Man, I'm glad Aflac pays cash.
Aflac? Ha!
Is it major medical?
Used for studio session as a portrait.
Yeah, yeah.
With
well,
the subject using of a large variety
vintage.
Of use this opportunity to capture.
I like it. Beautiful. Doesn't get warm. Like, right here, maybe? I don't know why, but right there, it's a little warm. But, like, not hot. It doesn't get hot. Which is quite impressive for an analog television. So. Feel free to leave a comment and subscribe. Don't even try to ask me for this television set, because I never sell my stuff. I like keeping it, because it's still working. Oh, got some crap in there, I never noticed that. Yeah, it's stuck like that. I don't know. It's the only disadvantage when you have glass like that, or plastic, I should say, in front of that. When there's stuff stuck behind it, it just gets in the way of the picture. But you don't notice it when it's on, right?
Middle set.
Middlestad is known for his meticulously detailed wildlife
painting. Okay. Well, that's it.